Greetings, everybody. We're back here on Saturday, 18th of December, 2021. This is our second session of the Sabbath today. And Michael has prepared for us session 81. And of course, we're on the topic of, I think we can call this deception, Michael.
Absolutely. Welcome, Michael. That's what I wanted to say. I wanted to take it over now. Deception, yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Absolutely.
And it happens to be, you know, one of those topics that we were, you know, influenced by at a young age, like you had mentioned in the previous session. On the movie E.T., for instance.
Mm. And you see here in the first book of Genesis, in the first book of the Bible, actually, it's been clearly depicted that it's just heaven and the earth. Yeah, that's the main focus of it all. Yeah, heaven and earth, and that in that order, of course, the spiritual and then physical. So the spiritual world has been created before the physical world. And it doesn't speak about the three creation, but the Freemasons and Atlantis and all the futile stuff is coming up. No, actually, it's been one creation here. Yeah, so there in the fourth day, on the fourth day, God said, "Let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven, divide from the night and the day from the night. Let them be signs for seasons and for days and years." Yeah, that's what the God's order told us to do. Two great lights. He's speaking about the earth and two great lights. That's it. That's about the astronomy of the Bible. Of course, and the stars, yes. But he made the stars also. Okay, that's it. And then he created animals. And the last one, or the last part of the creation, was man made in our image. Yeah, so what does that tell us? That there is no alien life form which is not being related to the creation of God. And God told us in the Bible that he made man in our image. So there cannot be any other civilization which has not been made by God. If you believe in God and you know that God created everything, everything means everything, every atom, every animal, every man, everything, every stone, everything, everything which is matter has been created by God. Everything has been created by God. Even spirits have been created by God. So there is nothing that you know that in, when you compare that in the book of John 1:1. Yeah, you have it absolutely clear. Would you like to read it in the beginning from verse 1 to verse 3 at least?
Okay. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. And without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that interesting, this last verse? Because you see that there is a positive and there is a negative. There is a light and then there is a dark, and the dark does not comprehend.
Mm.
Kind of like a black hole. I think of Michael in instances in our life when we share with others and we openly and freely share with others, and then they just shoot down everything that comes out of your mouth and completely disregard anything you have to say from that point on. And that to me is a black hole. And I have encountered many black holes in my life, Michael.
Yeah, isn't that interesting when there is a famous Roman historian, I think it was, or a Roman military guy who came up and said, was a quote like, the first reaction to truth is hate.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, if somebody is in the spirit of Satan, then he hates the truth. And so that the majority of people are on the broad way leading to destruction, of course, they will hate the truth. And you tell people the truth, they will hate you.
Yeah. Yeah, we're warned in the scriptures about that too.
Yeah.
Yeah, we are. I can look it up.
Yeah, therefore, people have been also been warned not to put pearls before the swine. So if somebody rejects us or you, and you don't run after him and said, you have to believe, because it's not in your power, it is in God's power. If somebody will be pushed out of the darkness into the real light, which is Jesus Christ in 8:12. Also in the same gospel, in the book of John, chapter 8:12, that Jesus testified of himself, said that I am the light of the world. Yeah. So therefore, you know that in the light shineth in darkness. So you know that Jesus Christ is the light, and the darkness comprehended it not. Of course, if you go into the chapter 8, would you like to read it?
Sure. This is John chapter 8, verse 12. Then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk, in darkness, but shall have the light of life.
Yeah, you spoke earlier about the two difference points between light or opposites about light and darkness. And when Jesus is the light, the counterfeit or the opposite is darkness, which is Satan. Of course, Satan is no God. No, don't get
because
those.
What does a counterfeit do, Michael? A counterfeit is a deception in and of itself. It tells you it's the truth, but in reality, it's a lie.
Mm-hmm.
But when everyone does it, does that make it right? Does that still make it right? When everyone does the lie, when they believe the lie, does that still make it okay?
Yeah, you see, in the same chapter of John, chapter 8, verse 44, I speak it of Satan. Would you like to read it?
Sure, yes. John, chapter 8, verse 44 reads, ye are of your father the devil, and the lusts of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no light in him. No, there is no truth in him, excuse me.
Which when is the same.
When he speaketh a lie, I just was automatically thinking that, and
yeah,
I said
yeah,
it.
Me too.
When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it.
Yeah, so if you know that Jesus Christ did create anything, he also created every creature, everything. So you cannot say there is an alien. Yeah, there is nothing alien. It's all part of the creation. There is not one part of the creation which has not been created by the creator. There is no second creator. There is no second earth. There is no second savior. It's just one. All in one. God, Son, and Holy Spirit. So, therefore, we go back to the script. What about UFO and aliens? UFO can be anything. It's not necessarily being equipped with aliens. And aliens, you see, that can be also everything. Let's go. Maybe it would be very wise, if I may say so, to go into terminology once again and look what they're telling us about aliens. No, not ale, not drinking. A foreigner, a citizen of a foreign land.
There
so
we
people
go.
Think, yeah, but it's not necessarily an extraterrestrial. Because there is no life. outside in the material way. They're only spirits. You see that in science fiction sense, being from another planet. Sorry, but the Earth is not a planet.
Yeah.
Yeah, you see that how deception is working, one lie after the other. So to sum it up, let's face the fact. Aliens been seen as a life form in outer space. The Bible does not confirm any life out of space. The Bible does not confirm extraterrestrials. Because everything is part of the creation. I know there is some arguments about some things, and I think that's also part of the agenda nowadays, but we are not ready to go into this. I have to do it a little bit more in a chronological way. Therefore, last time I was talking about Erich von Däniken, also that there was a pre-Adamitic creation and astronauts, maybe Jesus was an astronaut and all these weird things coming up, and we have been visited by alien life forms, extraterrestrials, visitors from outer space for thousands of years, and they went to Nazca in Chile, and they went to the what else? Yeah, you see that all the things been people are making big money out of it. Yeah. So I give you a couple of interesting sources. The first one source is coming up from Carol Rosen. Carol Rosen, this is just needs verification. It's a founder of the Institute of Security and Corporations in Outer Space, and also works as a speaker, author, educator, child psychologist, futurist, and military. I don't know what that here is.
Oh, that has to do with the literary movement, Mike.
Yeah, I think. And military strategist. She was the first female executive of an aerospace company working as a corporate manager of Fairchild Industries. She's the executive director of the Peace and Emergency Action Coalition for Earth Peace, Inc. and IDEA Foundation, as well as a World Peace Ambassador for International Association of Educators for World Peace. So much so. Rosen was the first woman to work as an aerospace executive at Fairchild Industries and is a leader and the original political architect in the movement to stop anti-satellite weapons and a strategic defensive initiative. That's what
SDI. Yeah.
SDI. That's what Reagan had come up with.
Yeah.
Yeah. In her time at Fairchild, Rosen served as a spokesperson for Dr. Werner von Braun, with whom she created the film and educational program It's Your Turn to expand the diversity of people working in science fields. And now we have to skip back. This is page 164. We have to skip back to the quote of last time when we were citing Ronald Reagan of his speech at the 42nd Congress. There it is. There it is. There it is. There it is. Okay, and that we will copy now because we have talked about that shortly in the last session. Also, you can look up that video here addressed to the 42nd session of the United Nations General Assembly in New York. Okay, so then let's skip it to 164. Oh, the extraterrestrials. Wow. So once again, Rosen served as a spokesperson for Dr. Werner von Braun, with whom she created the film and educational program It's Your Turn to expand the diversity of people working in science fields. The program won many awards, including the awards and la 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 la, etc., etc. And it's not interesting what she did, but interesting is that she had video, and this is still up on YouTube. And this is called The Last Card is Coming, Alien Attack Planned, 2012, Dr. Carol Rosen. In that video, she says, Werner von Braun, in the United States, the father of rocketry, we know that he was more or less the heir of Jack or Marvel Parsons. In my first meeting with him, and she was the official spokesperson for Werner von Braun, so she's not somebody, yeah, she's one who was in close contact with Dr. Werner von Braun. She says, Werner von Braun, the United States, the father of rocketry, in my first meeting with him, he talked about the weaponization of space is now first being based upon the evil empire. At that time, there will be certain wars against terrorists, and there would be a third war would be asteroids, and then he would repeat to me over and over and over again. Dr. Carol Rosen says the last card would be the extraterrestrial threat. Reagan is quoted. I occasionally think how quickly our differences worldwide would vanish if we were facing an alien threat from outside this world. I think it could not be more fitting than this. And yet, I ask you, is not an alien force already among us? We know that alien means a foreigner, only a foreigner. But he's speaking about here explicitly an alien threat from outside this world. So it cannot mean a foreigner, right, Brett?
Right, right.
Yeah? So outside this world. And Dr. Carol Rosen says, okay, Werner von Braun told her and warned her over and over again. Yeah? So there would be some things coming up, planned. She says about nations will go to war, and then it will be about terrorists, and then will be about asteroids, and then we would repeat to me over and over and over, and the last card would be the extraterrestrial threat. That's why the video has been called The Last Card is Coming. So if that interview is correct and this woman is correct and she was in contact with Werner von Braun, I think it is very fitting that she came up and talk about that subject, especially when Ronald Reagan is talking about an alien threat from outside his world. Yeah, so from that on, I think it's very interesting that that could be happen. That could happen to unite the people. You see, you have to have a universal threat. Yeah, a universal threat. If you would like to explain that or to translate that, you see that universal usually means Catholic, but a universal threat. Don't we have a universal threat in 2021? Just a question. Also something which you cannot see, yeah, which you have to believe in. It's just a belief system. Reagan is talking about an alien threat from outside his world, and Dr. Carol Rosen says that Werner von Braun said the last card would be the extraterrestrial threat. Yeah, one thing is clear, threat and threat. So they rule you with fear. It's always a threat. And I know that I found somewhere that they are being afraid of that a meteor can hit the Earth. Meteor hitting Earth. Yeah, you see that here, hitting Earth 2020, 2021, and maybe also 2022. These are the asteroids to worry about. Mm-hmm. An asteroid barely misses Earth last week and no one knew. Yeah, and no one also can verify that. Yeah, so they rule you by fear. It's fear-mongering once again. Dr. Carol Rosen also pointed out, Werner von Braun talked about chemical, viral, bacterial, bad, biological warfare. Isn't that very recent? Against whom we have to build space-based weapons? SDI, huh? And now they have come here, are now not UFOs, there are identified flying objects, she says. Yeah. So U means unidentified flying objects, but she's got the opinion or the truth or the meaning or what else, that there are already identified flying objects. Okay, so that's one video you would like to go into, maybe. Yeah, the last card is coming, alien attack planned. Yeah, you see that once again, her credentials seem quite official, and it's just another thing that we have to take it as granted, but you can start a research there. I'm not saying that she's absolutely correct. I'll just say you can start your research there. On the moon doggy script, which I used extensively for the NASA sessions, also there is one sentence that says our old friend Buzz Aldrin, allegedly the second man on the moon, allegedly 33 Freemason, has said that the Apollo 11 mission was being followed by a UFO on the entire trip. So if you would like to go down that road, I think it is very time wasting, because Buzz Aldrin has been known that he's always saying something, and then he says he's been wrongly quoted. Yeah. So the survey.nasa.gov, it shall look like an official site. If it is, I don't know. Says Edwin Aldrin recently came out in a special on the Science Channel and stated that the astronauts aboard Apollo 11 also identified objects which seem to have been following them. He also mentions that they were briefed not to talk about what they had seen. What does NASA have to say in response to this? What were these objects they all saw? And this site claims that the quotations were taken out of context. Yeah, it's just another thing that is a plausible denial or what else. And you cannot go into all the things, but they will never tell you the truth. I would say that it is highly likely that one of these cards, either meteorite or alien threat, will be played. Because that at the moment it seems that these alien threats or UFOs are being mentioned much more frequently than in the last 40, 50 years. So they are not being denied anymore. And so therefore I think that this agenda is soon approaching. That is just my train of thoughts. I cannot give any truth. But you see, they will use every deception possible. Because UFO does not mean an alien or an extraterrestrial, just means it's an unidentified flying object. Yeah, and one of them, of course, is Roswell incident. Yeah, where we talked about Area 51 a little bit of last time. Yeah, so yet it also covers Area 51, Bob Lazar, you know, Element 115, Majestic 12, A Man in Black, etc., etc. And also that's a religious thing, because there is, for example, realism. And this is a UFO religion, yeah, and also Scientology. And wait, wasn't there something about L. Ron Hubbard having made rituals together with Marjorie Cameron and Marvel Parsons? Yeah, these Scientology guys, they fool you with their Dianetics. My. Elite extraterrestrial beings, not necessary for UFOs, has nothing to do with that. That's interpretation. UFO sightings are sightings on outer space, especially of unidentified flying objects. So can be a fly in outer space, or a molecule or something like that, I don't know, or dust or what else, but I thought it is a vacuum there. So how do they fly? Propulsion is not possible, at least in my humble experience, without any oxygen. it's hilarious. Yeah, they don't go down to that road. Yeah, you see that this is estimation, that has nothing to do with truth, actually. Yeah. Within the UFO community, stories have spread that Neil Armstrong was reported to have witnessed multiple UFOs during Apollo 11. Yeah, Buzz Aldrin also says his words were taken out of context from an interview in 2005 about the incidents. Yeah, and don't mess with Buzz Aldrin. If he doesn't like your face and he's insulted, he will push you right in the face, as we have seen before in the NASA series. I'm going down another route. I don't know if that is correct, because I said I have very strange feelings about any official documents of CIA, FBI, any official government, states, and so. So we cannot prove anything, but it's just where you can start your research. And here is one thing coming up. If you have never come across Mr. Jack Vallee on his implications of the UFO phenomena, thinking aloud, interview with Jeffrey Mishlove, you really have missed something. I don't say that it is the truth. But what I can say is that I will show you the source of his claims after the stills of that interview. And now please fasten your seatbelts. You will never believe it if you would not have seen documents which can also be faked, of course. But really, please. Jacques Vallée, maybe it is much smarter. Maybe it is much smarter to tell you that this guy has some credentials, at least in this world. Okay, so who's Jacques Vallée? Jacques Vallée is an internet pioneer, computer scientist, venture capitalist, author, ufologist, and astronomer currently residing in San Francisco, California, and Paris. His scientific career began as a professional astronomer at the Paris Observatory. Vallée co-developed the first computerized map of Mars for NASA in 1963. He later worked on the Network Information Center for ARPANET, a precursor on the modern internet, as a staff engineer of SRI, International Augmented Research Center, under Douglas Eckbart. So that guy is a scientist, more or less. Huh? Education, etc. Early life. A degree in mathematics in the University of Paris, and an equivalent of a Master of Science in Astrophysics from the University of Lille in North of France. He began his professional life as an astronomer at the Paris Observatory. He was awarded the Jules Verne Prize for his first science fiction novel. So he also is pointing out novel. So you don't know what's right and what's wrong. Yeah, but this guy is very known in the scientific community. So let's hear it for Mr. Jacques Vallée. I don't think you ever ran into this guy, Brad.
No, I don't think so either.
Okay, so he is pointing out in that interview here that in that Watergate investigation, you know, there were burglars there, and the background was not the spying on another political party, more or less, but what I have learned, and it's not necessarily the truth, but what I experienced in looking for the Watergate scandal was that they not only have gotten illegal access to a building and then confiscated some documents, but that these documents are related to John F. Kennedy in the Watergate files. So what he is putting out here has something to do with John F. Kennedy. And I know that I ran into a Freemason, and he told me that, one of the reasons that Kennedy had to die was that he was getting aware of that the American government was in touch with aliens and all of this. And I'm not going down to that road at the moment. But you see that Watergate investigation has much to do, obviously, with JFK, with John F. Kennedy. And you know that John F. Kennedy was assassinated, not by a lone nut, of course. So once again, now, Jacques Vallée says, the Watergate investigation, it was discovered that there was a plan. Originated in the White House to surface a submarine on the coast of Cuba and paint the Second Coming of Christ over the island of Cuba using holograms. I'm not making that up. Really, he says that. The Second Coming of Christ over the island of Cuba using holograms, which is well within our technology today. The idea was that since there's a large Catholic population in Cuba, they would be so upset by this vision that this was saturate the communication channels. You know, the telephone system in Cuba would be destroyed or would be busy. That would saturate the telephone system in Cuba long enough for an invasion to take place. And that's all psychological warfare, but that kind of manipulation is well understood. And I have personally investigated several apparently genuine UFO cases. This is the Prince Charles hologram on NCTV7 video, where he's appearing thousands of miles away using the technology of a hologram. And also the Seventh-day Adventist Walter Veit is using a reference for Prince Charles being using a hologram on his video of the teletransportable Bright Glowing Princess. This is a German video. I'm sorry I didn't found the English video, but nevertheless, you see that something is materializing here. It's like the Star Trek beaming something like this. Okay, so this technology should have been used in the 1960s. Can you now imagine? Can you now imagine what kind of technology they have today? 60 years later, the Cuba crisis was in the beginning of the 1960s. There are many claims of Jacques Vallée. Of course, he's a scientist and he has several theories, and he's not necessarily in the Bible, so he's got many, many interesting points, but of course not the biblical points. And he says, for example, that he got five arguments against extraterrestrial origin and identified flying objects. These 5 points are: these close encounters are far more numerous than required for any physical survey of the Earth. So, and of course, it's not only limited to 1947, to Roswell. Second, the humanoid body structure of the elite aliens is not likely to have originated on another planet and is not biologically adapted to space travel. And that's a debatable quote, because you see that this opinion here, that has nothing to do with the truth. The human DNA, as we know it today, is suboptimal. Yeah, that's what the science would like to tell you. But I think that if we have the belief in being a divine creation, then our DNA is optimal. Yeah, of course we're not suited for space travel because there is no space travel. Yeah. Humans are still spiritual beings. They have the right to alter their DNA. Yeah. You see, this is opinion here. This is very dangerous path here, which we are soon
it's
now.
So absurd, isn't it?
Yeah, but this is not his arguments. You see, that is one guy here who's coming up on Quora.com, sure, who's repeating his arguments. Yeah, so we cannot blame Jacques Vallée about it. Yeah.
No.
Third, the reported behavior and thousands of abduction reports contradicts the hypothesis of genetic or scientific experimentation on humans by an advanced race. Yeah, this is all opinion here. The extension of the phenomenon throughout record human history demonstrates that UFOs are not a contemporary phenomenon. Yeah, it's been going on for a long time. Yeah, you can look upon that on every viewpoint, but you see, it's just opinion. Yeah. It's just opinion. Rewrite years of history. This is just opinion. This is absolutely BS here. But I just want to go on to Jacques Vallée, because he's making a valid point. Yeah, because in psychological warfare, the end justifies the means. This is a website here from Wade Bolson, 2016, Castro, the CIA, and Christ, the Second Coming. There are true stories so bizarre they read like fiction. This is one of them. On November 30, 1961, a second attempt to overthrow the Cuban dictator commenced, of course, because the first one, the Bay of Pigs, there was very unsuccessful. But in my belief, when I went into the research of Kennedy, I think it is more likely that the Bay of Pigs was designed to get rid of Kennedy more than anything else, because Castro was a Jesuit. Yeah, so why want to get rid of Castro? I think that was not the part of it. The part of it was to threaten the American publicity with all the warheads in Cuba from the Soviets, and also that this mission should fail from the Bay of Pigs, to blame it on Kennedy. That's because it has been created from the CIA, and afterwards John F. Kennedy has been caught. I have no official source for that, but I know that it's been highly circulated that he said he would splinter the CIA into 1,000 pieces, and that most likely is about the futile attempt to dethrone Fidel Castro. So he said he was so upset about the CIA, and the CIA consists mainly of Knights of Malta. So therefore, I suggest that the CIA wanted to get rid of Kennedy, or many other prominent people wanted to get rid of Kennedy, because he wanted to settle the things directly without the intervention of the so-called Secret Service. And we know that the Secret Service is controlled about the main Secret Service, which is called Propaganda Fide in the Vatican. Yeah, this is the mother of all Secret Service. Yeah. If you don't believe it, you don't have to believe it, then you go into this, you go into Propaganda Fide, yeah, from the Vatican. This is the main secret service. This is the spreading of the faith. Yeah? Don't believe me, you don't have to believe me. Do your own research. Yeah, Propaganda Fide. The Congregation for the Evangelization of the Population, or what else? Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples. Congregatio Fide. Propaganda Fide. That's where you got this propaganda. Seat of the Congregation. Yeah? Since 399 years. Much more older than the United States of America. Okay, let's get back. General Lansdale and his agents designed a plan to try and convince the people of Cuba that the second coming of Christ had arrived. Fidel Castro was the Antichrist. Jesus wanted the people of Cuba to overthrow the Antichrist. How the Department of Defense and the Central Intelligence Agency proposed to execute a fake second coming of Jesus Christ to overthrow Castro is revealed by Assistant Deputy Director for National Intelligence Programs Thomas A. Parrott in his 1974 report to the United States Senate. Huh? It's like a parrot here, parroting. And if you don't believe this, what this website says, or what Jacques Vallée says, I have looked it up today. This is a document, alleged assassination plots involving foreign leaders. This is on page 153 in the PDF, which is page 142. Yeah, you see that here absolutely clearly this is Mongoose. And I have to look it up if I have to. Oh, where's my mouse now? Oh, where's my mouse now? Mouse. Oh, there's Miles. Yeah, there it is. This is one source. Yeah, then it's this. But I know that I have it on archive, alleged. Yeah, this is alleged assassination plots involving foreign leaders, because I can enhance it here a bit. So you see that it has something to do with Operation Mongoose. Okay, Mr. Lansdale. And now we look at the footnotes, okay? I will read it for you. Parrott sarcastically characterized Lansdale's plans as follows, quote, I'll give you one example of Lansdale's perspicacity. Oh my. I'll give you one.
Wait, yeah, I'm not familiar with this word. Sorry.
Okay. Oh, so then we have to look it up. Scharfsinn. Okay. Perspicacity. Oh, my.
There you go.
That's a hard word.
It is.
Okay. Okay, so Parrott sarcastically characterized Lansdale's plans as follows, quote, I'll give you one example of Lansdale's perspicacity. He had a wonderful plan for getting rid of Castro. This plan consisted of spreading the word that the second coming of Christ was imminent and that Christ was against Castro, who was Antichrist, and you would spread this word around Cuba, and then on whatever date it was that there would be a manifestation of the thing. And at that time, this is absolutely true, and at that time, just over the horizon, there would be an American submarine which would surface off of Cuba and send up some star shells. And this would be the manifestation of the second coming, and Castro would be overthrown. Well, some wag called this operation and somebody dubbed this elimination by illumination, unquote. Yeah, so you make your mind up. Is that deception or is that truth? But nevertheless, if it is what it is, but it indicates that they would use every means possible. Yeah, every means possible. Yeah, you see, this is the valid content here in that on that regard. Yeah, and there's more to it, especially this apparition. So it's very interesting. But you see that if we are into the UFO and alien things in Area 51, what would you suppose? You see that the ones who can or are able to provide such a vision 100 years ago are the ones who've been able to provide a vision in 2021 or 2022 or 2030. What I would like to point out is that we cannot tell the difference from the internet. If we would be live in there, maybe we would have a clue, but we cannot judge here right from wrong. And so this is once again, this is a vision of the television, a vision from far away. You can be fooled, you can be easily manipulated into believing that these things are real. Even if they are real, you cannot know if it has been artificially faked by some projectors or light source or military apparatus. Or if it's really coming from the spiritual world. That's a hard time thinking about that. But that's a big problem. You see that if you go into this kind of matters, it's mainly belief. Yeah, you see that at the same time when people hear the word UFO, they believe in aliens. And at the same time, if you speak about an apparition, people, or Mary apparition, people think about in religious terms, but maybe it's just to fool the people, especially in Latin America countries. Yeah, so that in Argentina, of course, if there is something coming down or been apparently visible, then it's not necessarily the truth. I think if they can make a hologram and project it into a dark room, then they can do much more than that, but they will not reveal that to us. And I think that's one of the main reasons of so-called Area 51. They are promoting things, they are developing science, which is hidden to us, and we believe, or we have to believe, it's coming from outer space. Yeah, think of that way. If they don't want to know you, that you know, they don't want you to know that they have crafts or techniques which can manipulate you into believing that the things you see are quite real by using holograms, by using transportation systems, by using light beams, by achieving tremendous speeds, then you won't know because it's a restricted area. Yeah, so that's my point in it. Yeah, you see that these people have only the approach from the worldly view, but not the approach of the biblical view. These are only scientists, so they don't look to the Bible that Jesus Christ created everything. So they actually believe there is a possible search for alien contact. Yeah, and these are also quotes from an interesting book called from Jacques Vallée called Forbidden Science. Yeah. But when I see that a certain guy of Robert Anton Wilson has made a remark of that book, that's a guy that's also an author, a fictional author, Robert Anton Wilson. I think it was the same guy who came up with the novel Illuminati. Yeah, so that's giving me a hard time, especially Robert Anton Wilson. Yeah, Illuminatus. Yeah, Illuminati. Yeah. That was giving me a hard time, especially when I know that Mr. Jacques Vallée, what we have learned so much, that Jacques Vallée has also worked for the NASA. Yeah, He developed a computerized map for the NASA in 1963. So that guy is not a private researcher or something. He's in the system. And that's really strange, because if you go into all these UFO things, close encounters, and the more traditional observations of entities described as angels, elves, and fairies or deities, skeptics insist that superior beings, celestial ambassadors, or intelligent extraterrestrials, so-called ETIs, visitors simply would not perpetrate such antics as are reported in the literature. Would you like to go that down to that road? I don't think so. You see that Jacquali has come up with a six-layer model for anomalous phenomena. He's not coming up with the truth. He's coming up from a model. So look at this from maybe psychological approach and a scientific approach. But it's just science. It's not biblical science. Biblical science clearly speaks there are no aliens out there. Yeah. Interesting that one of his books is called Messengers of Deception, UFO Contacts and Cults. Uh-huh. Messengers of Deception. You know what messengers are in the Bible, Brett?
Could be... Oh. I almost want to say angels?
Yeah, absolutely. Angels are messengers. Yeah. You see?
That's what I thought. Yeah.
Revelation 9:15. And the four angels were loosed. So angel, Agelos, yeah, a messenger.
Right.
And now we compare that. The angels of deception.
Correct.
Who are the angels of deception in the Bible?
Yeah, that's easy. The fallen angels.
The fallen angels, yes. It's okay, it's close. You would not have to read that book.
Right.
Yeah. Right. So Messengers of Deception, he has been clawed here. Dr. Vallée was born in France, where he received his Bachelor of Science degree in Mathematics from the Sorbonne and a Master of Science in Astrophysics from the University of Lille. Where is that valid point? I was his website, because this book claims that his website is jacquesvallee.com, but actually his website is jacquesvallee.net. Based in Silicon Valley, Jack has served as founder and general partner in five venture funds, including NASA's Red Planet Capital. Bam! Hmm. Yeah. Red Planet, of course, is Mars. Huh? It's a planet of war. So we read that sentence again. Based in Silicon Valley, Jack has served as a founder and general partner in five venture funds, including NASA's War Capital.
Yeah.
Yeah, life can be easy, huh? When you have 80 sessions behind you. Hmm? Life can be easy. So I don't have to read. I know that he's not a biblical guy. I don't have to read much further.
No.
Interesting enough. You see that if I read books and they say that, oh, we had just run a Christmas party at the observatory.
There we go. Pagan Central,
yeah. And I got other videos, which I started the session. I said, oh, yeah, there's a cosmic hoax, a very interesting video, which then all of a sudden it says, oh, yes, universal peace. And I said, oh, that's a Catholic. That's a Catholic word. Yeah, I saved it. I said that last grass. That's a Catholic term, which means Catholic peace. And we know that. What does the Bible say about peace? Not the peace of this world, huh? What Jesus Christ says, not the peace. Yeah. Yeah, Matthew 10:31.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword.
Uh-huh. Yeah, there's also some other. Yeah, this is John 14:27. That is the very verse I meant.
Okay, here it is. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid.
Yeah. So it is not the peace of the world. Yeah. If somebody comes up in the video and says, oh yeah, universal peace, I'm not skipping it back now because I know that we mentioned it in this or in the last episode. Yeah, this is Dr. Greer from that video, The Cosmic Hoax and Expose. Yeah, but the video itself is a hoax. And now it gets very strange because Dr. Stephen Greer is promoting a contact app to spirits called CE5 Contact.
Jeez.
And that's where I said, okay, this is a candidate for this series.
Ah, yeah. CE5 Contact. Yeah. Gee, what can we tell our listeners about that? Five Eyes of Lucifer, Isaiah 14, was it, Michael?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, CE5 Contact on the App Store. The CE5 protocols were developed by Dr. Stephen Greer, one of the world's foremost authorities on the subject of UFOs, extraterrestrial intelligence, and this is an app for an apple. An initiation peaceful, not the peace of this world, actually, peaceful contact with interstellar civilization. Dr. Grant's relentless efforts towards the disclosure of classified UFO ET information have inspired millions of supporters around the world. Huh? That's great, huh? My. So they want you to get in contact with the spiritual world.
Yeah, but not the spiritual world of the scriptures.
Oh, not necessarily. The evil side of the messengers from the gods.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But you see, these are no ordinary people. Yeah, these are people who are educated. These are people who are running big companies and you've been famous throughout decades. Yeah, an American ufologist who founded the Center for the Study of Extraterrestrial Intelligence and a disclosure project which seeks the disclosure of alleged classified UFO information. He receives a BS degree. Oh, a BS degree is very hilarious, but I thought of something else, Brett, sorry.
Sure.
A Bachelor of Science is a bachelor's degree awarded for programs that generally last 3 to 5 years in biology from the Appalachian State University and a Doctor of Medicine degree from the College of Medicine in East Tennessee. Yeah, so you can't say that these people are just loonies and losers and cannot come up with a proper education or so. These are the educated people who think of themselves as being enlightened Luciferians. They really strive to get contact to the spiritual world. Yeah, you can hide it by using SETI and UFO and alien, but you see, actually, it is something from outer space, yeah, or out of the earth. Extraterrestrial means out of the earth. Terra means earth. It's Latin once again. That's what they all try to do. And it was in the days of Noah. Peter Weiland at TED 2023. I will change the world. They all want to change the world. Interesting enough that our old researcher here says the occult will introduce it as a new science. Which means the spiritual contact to spiritual entities and not necessarily good entities. So even if you are looking for a UFO or you're looking for an alien contact or extraterrestrials, it means you don't follow the Bible. You are following the path of the scientists who are bleeding you with science. That's the big problem with it. Yeah, because a man who chooses safety and security is a slave, no matter how much money he has. Because you got no ground. And the people who are in the darkness, who are looking especially for extraterrestrials and all this stuff, they are absolutely in the darkness because they don't know what is where they're coming from. They don't know their purpose in life, and they don't know where they are going to.
There's that verse we started with.
Yeah. Where's that verse? Yeah. And therefore, it is this spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Who wants the people to get in contact? Because the more people are being deluded and deceived, yeah, the bigger the so-called army of Satan, or would you like to say the army of the fallen angels or what else, is going to be. That is the so-called age of enlightenment. But he's not bringing the right light. Yeah, he's blinding you with science. The dragon, that old serpent, called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world by science. And his messengers were cast out with him. So we were speaking about Area 51, which is a military tool or a military instrument where they have top secret facilities where who wants to know what they are doing there? Because Area 51, the name, shall resemble of an old map. Now that's what I discovered, that they said it is an old map. What is Area 51? The infamous legend of the real Area 51 took flight in 1954 when President Eisenhower assigned the United States Air Force the task of tracking down a remote and highly concealed location for aircraft training and testing. They found it in the middle of nowhere, deep in the Rush Desert of Nevada. This area, named as a reference based on its geographical location, was given the moniker Area 51. Okay. Or extraterrestrials or what else. So, but there could be another reason why it has been named Area 51. It could be. I cannot prove it, but could be. But I think that at the end of this very exhausting sessions, because I have to think about so many things, and I would like to incorporate a little bit more Bible in here, I am sorry, I have to go down the occult way once again, because you see that Scientology goes the path, and realism. Also, this is a so-called UFO religion, does it too. We came to realism, actually, when we were going into Genesis, Peter Gabriel, because the lamp lies down on Broadway, the main character has been named Ra'el. And so realism is a UFO religion that was founded in 1970s, interesting, eh? And the same period when Genesis were doing A Lamp Lies Down on Broadway. Scholars of religion classify realism as a new religious movement. The group is formalized as the International Raelian Movement Church, hierarchical organization under Rael's leadership. Realism teaches that an extraterrestrial species known as the Elohim, huh? You know where that comes from? From the first word of God in the Bible. Created humanity using their advanced technology. An atheistic religion, it believes that the Elohim has historically been mistaken for gods. It claims that throughout history, the Elohim have created 40 Elohim-human hybrids, which have served as prophets preparing humanity for news about their origins. Among those considered prophets are Buddha, Jesus, and Muhammad, with Ra'el himself being the 14th and final prophet. Sure, yeah, everybody wants to be his own guru. Realists believe that since the Hiroshima bomb of 1945, humanity has entered an age of apocalypse in which it threatens itself with nuclear annihilation, etc. You know where it all comes down from? That the UFO is a religion. So the belief into things which you cannot explain is a religion. And it's the same situation out there. Yeah, and even Genesis with their lamp lies down on Broadway. The lamp lies down on Broadway. Their main character is called Ra'el. You don't have to believe me. I'll show you. A concept album with a story devised by Gabriel about Rael, a Puerto Rican youth from New, etc., etc. Bizarre incidents and characters all along the way. Very bizarre when you look upon that figure here, which is shining white or white. So it's spirit. And now we know that Raelism is from the 1970s and The Lamb Lies Down on Broadway is from 1974, if I remember correctly. 1974. So we talked about that, I think, briefly. But now you see that they have biblical references with Elohim here and Jesus, of course. So this is also a religion. The belief in UFOs is also a religion. So what if it is all a secret military program, also maybe a little bit influenced by the occult, thinking about the old ties from Marvel Parsons, Marjorie Cameron, and L. Ron Hubbard. Then I have found something, and I think that closes down the session quite briefly. Who other could it be than the master himself? Talking about the book The Lost Continent by Aleister Crowley. You might think for yourself, why The Lost Continent? The Lost Continent is supposed to be Atlantis, which is a pre-Adamitic creation. Oh yeah, pre-Adamitic, that means that it could be that there was once a creation, but it disappeared. But it's like Erich von Däniken with his Chariots of the Gods. Yeah, every resemblance to a creation before Adam and Eve is purely unbiblical and untrue. So it's fiction, it's mythology, it's mystery, and it's paganism. And now Aleister Crowley writes a book about the lost continent. Okay. You know what the alternative title for that book is? I'll show you. Aleister Crowley's The Lost Continent, Liber 51, purports to be a history of the lost continent of Atlantis, but is more of a subtle, hilarious satire on Crowley's contemporary British society. In this short work, the author managed to lampoon British social structure, politics, marriage, religion, education, child-rearing, sexual relations. Crowley has also inserted small jewels of occult knowledge which shine brightly to those who can discern them. The best description of Liber 51 comes from the author himself. Quote, "At times, it is a fantastic rhapsody describing my ideals of utopian society. Some passages are a satire on the conditions of our civilization, while others convey hints of certain profound magical secrets or anticipations of discoveries in science." From Aleister Crowley's Confession. Liber 51 means L.I. is an exceptional example of the literary craft. So Area 51, of course, is the 51st state of the United States. What is the 51st state? You know, Crowley, by the way, lived only until 1947, and he was aware of that famous or infamous Roswell incident. But the Area 51 was named and created in 1954, when his book was already been published and Crowley was already dead, and Roswell already did happen 7 years ago. So what shall convince me that 51 came up from a map of Nevada? Or could it be that A, there is a reference to Aleister Crowley once again, because we know that when it is in the United States Air Force and tests facilities are on Area 51, it is very, very secret, and it has maybe something to do with extraterrestrials, then we know it's the old thing about the path of Crowley and Lamb. Yeah, so go down the path of Crowley and Lamb. And then you compare that to a gray alien. Or an alien maybe in the form of a close encounter of the third kind. So this is a 1918 drawing of Lamb. 1918. And this is a spirit, actually, which has supposedly talked over his left shoulder, Liber al Legis, or the Book of the Law, to Aleister Crowley. So that is a demon. So that means that the idea of an extraterrestrial also is a demon. That means a messenger of the God, but of the God of this world. So that means of Satan. So that is, has everything to do with gray aliens or with extraterrestrials or UFOs being inhabited by aliens. Everything to do with evil spirits or demons. Would you like to call it fallen angels? I don't care. It's always the same. It's always the same. But this is Crowley as the originator. It has nothing to do with the gray alien, because that was 1918. And now compare it with two thoughts. The first thought is that these books have been printed and his theory. There are several suggestions what 51 also could mean. The first one is that Aleister Crowley was the one who was in touch with the spiritual world, or if you would like to call them, a small hint, extraterrestrials, because they are not of this earth, they are of the spiritual world. They are not of this earth. So extraterrestrial does not necessarily mean a living organism. It can also mean a spirit, because it is not of this earth. It has not been born on this earth, so to speak. It has not been born by a woman. So the first possibility would be the Liber 51. It's an utopian novel, magical secrets, discoveries in science, which would fit a bit. But it would fit very much if we know that the whole Area 51 mythological legend and Roswell incidents is about aliens, is about visiting from other planets, universes, areas, what else? Yeah. So it's about contact to the evil spirits. And the last thing before Brett has his closing comments on that is, of course, that the United States consists of 50 counties, yeah, from Alaska to Hawaii and Florida, etc. Don't forget Nevada, Minnesota, and all the other, Ohio, and what else?
Wisconsin.
Texas, Wisconsin, yeah. Delaware, so all the things that I know of, Washington, D.C., Washington, D.C., especially. So what is the 51st? Either, yeah, in Germany, many would say that, oh yeah, this is Germany, because you see that Germany was being occupied and is still occupied by Allied forces, although the government does deny that. But that's not the main thing.
Well, some say Israel.
Some say Israel, but I think that's maybe it is also the in the 50s, but you cannot see it. Yeah. So maybe 51 is a resemblance of 50 plus something. Maybe it is a spiritual world, but maybe also it's just one other country which has a similar
District of Columbia. Just kidding.
Isn't that incorporated in the 50 states?
No, I don't think so. The District of Columbia is a lot like the Vatican. It's outside of the
Now you're spoiled.
Right. Well, I mean, if you really want to know, that's my thoughts on it.
Yeah, that's my thoughts too. Yeah, so that means that the 51st state actually is as well as Washington, D.C., as is the Vatican.
Sure.
There is no other deception that is known to me that would have such a strong effect on politics and military and things coming from outer space that would absolutely serve the agenda. Then people would fell for the idea, for the religious belief of so-called realism, that there is something being the creator, the creation happened from outer space, and these people shall visit us or will visit us in the near future. That's my point of it, this realism. Yeah, you see that realism actually is a very new religion from 1970s, but the Order of Angels, yeah. Yeah, that's, it does not matter. You see, that's an international religion. That science is a new religion. And realism is a very new religion from the 1970s. Using, of course, some form of a hexagram. 666. It's just the same all over again. Yeah.
Or 6 times 6 looks like, you know,
the Elohim on Earth, the Age of Apocalypse.
Remember what? Isn't that interesting, Michael? 6 times 6 is 36, and we remember 36 deacons from the the astrological thing, and also to do with was it? Oh, help me out here, Michael. The 36 deacons of Babylon, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's Babylonian.
Yeah. Yeah, it's Chaldean, I think it was. Yeah, Babylonian, Chaldean. Yeah, it's the same. But I just wanted to point out that the belief in extraterrestrials can also be lived in a religious community called realism. Yeah, somebody who has not followed our satanic media agenda exposed with Peter Gabriel or Genesis might not know realism. And it's not the big deal, actually. It's just a part of that. You see, you can also go into Scientology and all this stuff. But the thing is that everybody who is into believing into aliens, ETs, and UFOs and so is believing in there has to be a life outside in the universe. Yeah. Today, I followed an interview of a famous German astronaut. And he says, yeah, of course, the universe is so big and therefore there has to be life. Yeah, well, he knows. Oh, you see that astronaut, huh? How hilarious, funny. How hilarious, funny. I at the moment, I have forgotten his name. German astronaut, I think. Astronaut, I think it was Ulrich, or what else? Ulrich Walter, yeah, that's the guy, yeah. Yeah, sometimes my memory is working. Yeah, Ulrich Walter. Yeah, he was a former astronaut. Yeah, yeah, he says that of course the universe is so so enormous and infinite, there must be life somewhere. Yeah, sure. If you wear that badge, yeah. If you serve the Columbia, yeah. Then you serve the Knights of Columbus or who else, I don't know, but you see that these guys are, he was on the Space Shuttle Columbia on his mission STS-55 as a payload specialist, 9 days, 23 hours and 40 minutes in space. That's always the same people. These people are smart, but these people are all Luciferians, of course. And I found an interview with him. Yeah, that's it about Area 51, about some interesting thoughts. Of course, we cannot know what's really going on there, but I think we have provided you a bunch of interesting names and sources. Read the Bible and you know there are no extraterrestrials. If there are extraterrestrials, then there are spirits. So what the Vatican has to do with that, that will be the subject of the session 82. I think I need a break. I think Red needs a break too. And I hope that you will be ready for the next upcoming session. And I hope you have a good time in between. And please read your Bible. There you see all the truth and everything else. It's very time consuming, but nevertheless, I hope I did some research for you so that you can start on your own and you can read your Bible with new intentions, and you then know that God created everything and there is no outside civilization. These are just spirits, and many secret services are making it overtime. I'm working overtime to give you all the illusions you like to see, like a big Hollywood movie, like Independence Day or Close Encounter of the Third Kind. It will be very interesting to learn what their deceptions will be in the near future. So let's meet again next time. Thank you very much for having me. God bless and Maranatha.
Thanks, Michael. We'll catch up with everyone next time. And Maranatha.